Everybody, welcome to Canvas Kids. I'm Miss Cindy, and this week we're going to be painting koi fish. So it's koi fish in a pond. So the first thing we are going to do is grab my paper plate, and I'm going to take white and a tiny bit of black. So I'm going to put some white on my plate and just a tiny bit of black and mix it together just a little bit because you want it kind of streaky. You don't want it all blended. And then go ahead and paint the two fish. This little guy over here is supposed to be orange, so paint the big one and paint the little one over there. And paint them in the gray. Now, if it's still streaky like it's supposed to be, your fish will look streaky on the canvas, too. If you go over the line, don't worry about it because the blue is dark enough for the water that it'll hide where you went over. So I'm actually going over just because I want to do it quick for you. Use some of this white that's on here. There we go. Going over the line just so I can hurry for you. Okay. You can still see the lines anyway. So you don't want your fish real gray. So if your fish looks too gray and not white enough, or I should say light enough, go back when it's dry. And add some more white to it. So once it gets dry, go back over it with a little bit more white if yours is too dark looking, because you don't want a dark gray fish. You want them very light colored, but you do want some gray in him. I'm going to add some to mine while he's wet just because I don't have the time to wait till he dries. Okay, so now with your third fish, you want to paint the whole fish orange. Now, I have a different orange because I grabbed the wrong one for myself. So what I am going to do is I am going to put this, I should have just mixed it in there. I'm going to take the light orange and I'm going to add a tiny bit of red to it. You won't have to do this because you have the correct orange. I just didn't grab the right one. So I'm trying to darken my orange to look like yours. Close enough. So go ahead and take your orange and paint your third fish. And try to paint your fish kind of lightly so you don't end up with a really wet fish. Okay. All right. So now that your fish is painted orange, go ahead and take your blue. I'm going to use the bigger brush. Not sure if I told you to do the water next or the lily pads, but we're going to do the water next because we want the water to dry. So go ahead and take your blue, and you're going to paint. First, I would outline around your fish. And this is just so when you're painting it, you don't accidentally go over the line when you paint a whole bunch. And then same thing, paint around the lily pads. Try not to paint it too heavy though, like I just did. And then because I have this side over here, I'm going to do it. And when you paint around the fish, use your brush to go the direction of around the fish. Because you want him to look like he's floating through the water. And he's pushing the water aside. So you want it to like look like there's movement in the water. And try to paint your blue as light as you can, not too heavy. All right, I'm going to turn this. Outline this one. See how I'm painting the direction around the fish? So it looks like he's moving through the water. And the water's moving with him, if you see the brush strokes from it. You don't have to worry about it around the lily pad though. Not so much. Okay. But your dark blue should hide any place you went over with the gray onto the water area because the blue's so dark. And then go ahead and paint the whole water area. You guys just take your time, do it the best you can, no hurry for you. I'm going to try to hurry though, so your video is not too long. Make sure you don't leave any patches of white where you missed going around the fish and you left the empty spot on the canvas. When your water is all done, however you, I would let it dry before you continue on with what I'm telling you. Okay, we're going to let it dry. Oopsie. Went a little bit over on that little guy. I'm trying to cover up where he turned green. See if you make any mistakes with the orange or the gray. You can always cover them up with the blue. But you can't really the other direction. Fix it. Okay, so while that is drying, we're going to go ahead and make some spots on our fish. The two fish that are gray are going to have, see, some spots on them. You can do your spots wherever you want, however many you want. I would use the orange and the red, or a combination. And don't make them like perfectly round or anything like that, because they're supposed to be kind of freeform shaped. Not supposed to have a perfectly round like spot. And then kind of paint them on the edge like that, so it looks like it's down the side of the fish. You kind of make them kind of lumpy looking. I'm just going to do three on that one. And I'm going to turn this so I can reach this better. Oops, got a little blue in it. See, make sure your water is dry, or you're going to end up with a little blue in yours, just like I just did. And then I'm going to go back and I'm going to put a little red on some of them. This one I'm going to make just a red one right over here. A little bit on there. The same thing with my all orange fish, as I'm going to kind of brush a little red on him so he's got more color to him. Got to tell you to do that while he was wet. You can do it while it's dry. Just do like a really dry brush and a tiny, tiny bit of red. Like take a little red on your brush and then wipe most of it off and then go back and put it on here a little bit. Oh, I have to turn it again or I'm going to end up with a blue hand. A little bit of red to these. Okay. All right, while the water part is drying, I am going to go ahead and take my green, and now I'm going to paint the lily pads. So go ahead and paint your lily pads. When you paint them, try to follow the shape of the lily pad. So where it's round, try to keep your brush going the round direction. You don't want to stripe this way. You want it to go this way with the shape of the lily pad. Like that. You can do that to get the edges, but then go back over it so you get the stroke marks from your brush going the right direction. Next one. Take your time when you're doing yours. I'm just doing them fast to hurry up for you. Okay. Turn this around again. Have to paint these very heavy, but if you do, not the end of the world, because we're not doing anything else really with them, so you won't smear them or anything. Okay, last one. And even if a little bit of your blue from your water gets in there, it doesn't matter. All it's going to do is add more color to it. See, you can always do different directions just to get it covered. But then go back over it the correct direction and it'll look much better. See? Okay. Now that we're done with that, I'm going to take a little bit of white. And if your fish are dry, do this step. If it's not dry yet, don't do it yet. I'm just going to take a little bit of white and I'm going to make a line right down the back, kind of lightly, because you just want it to look like the light from the sun is reflecting on the top of your fish. That's what we're doing it for. Now let me stop and get the paint off my hand. Okay, so now make sure your water is dry, because if it's not dry, this part's not going to work. Okay, let me wipe off this brush. Gets too much paint on the handle and I end up with it all over me. Okay, so now you need a very, very dry brush to to make the fins. So take the white, dry your brush really good, take that tiny bit of white on the end where it almost hardly looks like your brush has got anything on it. And what you want to do is you want to lightly dry brush it. So you just want to kind of do this to it. You can also do the edge of a brush like this. But see, the white is coming up with the blue and it's coming out with a light blue fin because my blue wasn't dry enough. Make sure your blue is dry enough before you do this. Even though it looks like it was dry and it felt like it was dry, it definitely was not dry. I'm going to show you what to do though, even though it's going to still come up blue. But that's how you want to do your fins that are on the sides of the body. Just look at the example where the fins are. And then what you want to do for the tail is you just kind of want to do the same thing. It's going to keep going blue though, the more I put on here. But see how you want it to get kind of like this on the end. You don't want it solid, you want those pieces like that. So you could see each of the brush strokes, because it wouldn't look as nice if it was just solid. But do it however you can do it. If you can't do it this way, then don't worry about it. Do it how you can. And even though mine is blue, pretend like he's not blue. And besides using the white, you also want to add a little bit of the orange to it, which mine's just going to turn to green. Oh, this is what happens when you can't wait for paintings to dry. And you want to add a little bit of red to it. But see, you want to do it where it's light, so it's just a little bit blended in with your white or your orange. You don't want to make, if you can help it, you don't want to make a solid line like this for a fin. You want it to be more like you can see each of the brush strokes in between, because the fins on the fish are a lot of times are more see-through, so that kind of looks like it then. So you want to do all the fins on your fish, and you also want to do the tails of the ones that are showing. See, like this one, it's more wispy looking like that. That's how you want it. And this side's very wet looking. I can see the blue already. There we go. So just do it the best you can. Just make sure you do all of your fish that way, or however you can. And also now, go through, and don't forget your eyeballs on your fish, because I almost did. So go ahead and put your eyes on your fish. They're only like a half an eye because it's kind of on the side. So you don't want a round circle on the top of your head. You want just a half circle on the end like that. That's a terrible one. Well, he's got a big eye now. Okay. We're going to pretend like he's got all of his fins too. So after you're done making the black part of the eye, when the eye is dry, go ahead and take a little white and just make a tiny dot right in the middle somewhere. Just a tiny one, however small you can make it. All right. Now, I also forgot to tell you to make some white marks in the water. So take your brush, a fairly small brush, and take a little bit of white paint, and you want to make some little lines around your fish because you want it to look like the water is moving from the fish moving. So you don't want it, you don't have to have a great big line or anything, but you want a little lines that go around him because he's swimming through the water, so the water is moving. So just like that. You can make some like double lines. You can have one next to another like that for the bigger spots. And I think, yep, one more step. Thought I'd put it on here. Take a little bit of, get another paper towel. Take a little bit of your green. And either a little bit of black or a little bit of blue. I'm going to use a little bit of black. You're just trying to make a dark green. So you could add either one to it just to make a different color green that's a little darker. So once you get your darker green, just outline your lily pads a little. Just so they show up a little bit better. You don't have to worry about them being perfect. You just want to highlight your lily pads a little by doing that. Just makes them show up a little bit better. And if you painted them and they went over the blue from the water, you might already have some lines there anyway, so it's fine. So just like that, just so they're highlighted a little bit. And I think that is it then. Let me check my notes real quick, if this is the other one. All right, we are done. Don't forget to put your initials on there. Remember, pretend like my fish have all of his fins and his tail. But you just kind of do it like that. But you have to really make sure it's dry. I mean, really dry. Otherwise, it's just going to keep going through it. All right, and that is it. And thanks for coming. And I hope you sign up for next session. Bye.